Ladies and gentlemen, Mike Coots.
Aloha, and welcome to this very special presentation full of hope, amazement, and joy. A pure celebration of our lives and our very best selves. There are stories to be told of those who have championed through some of the toughest odds, including some of life's most insidious and impossible challenges. My name is Mike Coots, and I speak from personal experience. 19 years ago, I was enjoying the beautiful warm waters off of Kauai when I was attacked by a large female tiger shark who took my right leg as a stolen trophy. It was the most incredible, surreal experience of my life. When I became two, I was at Wilcox Memorial and basically started a new life. I had no idea of the great gift that was to be bestowed upon me. With tremendous will and endless support from the Wilcox team, recovery and rehabilitation became part of a new and amazing life. A little over a month, I was back in the water, and I have a newfound respect for sharks and an overwhelming gratitude to Wilcox, who helped me understand that my situation did not and does not define who I am. Mine is just one of the endless tales of the incredible feats by Hawaii Pacific Health. There are so many miracles that happen every day, and we who are part of this presentation are just a mere snippet of their scope. Each of these beautiful survivors has endured. No, they haven't endured, they've thrived because of the support, strength, and love bestowed upon us. I hope you feel the love from us tonight right back at you. Ladies and gentlemen, beautiful survivors.
I had unstable pelvic fracture, emergency surgeries to save the left leg, which now is functioning and able to climb mountains, run marathons, and go anywhere. I knew beyond a shadow of a doubt that I would walk again. There was no question in my mind that I would be healed absolutely.
I was training for a bodybuilding contest. 10 weeks out of the competition is when my heart stopped and my life changed forever. Firemen were called by my students. One of the firemen continued chest compressions all the way until the ambulance dropped. They came back to my classroom the following year and they brought a lady in the fire truck on the first day of school. You know, this illness has knocked me down on my face, but damned if I'm gonna let this kill me.
I had on the inside of both knees, no cartilage at all. It was just bone on bone. I literally couldn't walk without pain. So I finally said, you've got to go see Dr. Nakasone at Straub. It's just given me back my life.
This is wonderful being 70 years old
and I can do everything I want to do. That's major.
It's a feeling like a born again teen, got a heartbeat like we're only 16.
Dr. B, he's a cool doc, and he's like, you have heart failure. And then I was just kind of like, okay, he's not a nice doctor just coming to say hi here. He's telling me that I have something wrong with me. I only go home and eat shaved ice. And yeah, I never went home that day. And I didn't go home for the next 7 months. Heart transplant taught me that everyone deserves a second chance and give without expecting anything back.
Dr. Kozak at Straub, she's just hilarious. I love her. So he goes, Mr. Cook, for 39 years, I've asked you to get a colonoscopy and you refuse. He said, now you have to get one.
And I got a little nervous because I figured, uh-oh, all my bad habits are going to catch up with me. I go out on my boat a lot more, so I'm just enjoying life. I'm really enjoying life now.
I changed the law. Requiring dense breast notification was one of the most remarkable experiences of this whole cancer journey for me. If you need me, call me. No matter where you are, no matter how far. Don't worry, baby, just call out my name. I'll be there in a hurry. You don't have to worry, cause baby,
looking ahead, not looking back, and I want to enjoy life. I realized that millions of people have cancer. At that point, it was, okay, no pity party. This is something that you had to do, and I made up my mind I wasn't going to die. HPH's philosophy has changed to building a healthier Hawaii. It has to do with a way of life, building strong community, and helping one another.
Can't nurse's aide at Kapilani. I work much harder now. When I see other moms come in with their child with the same issue, I talk to them about it, and it makes them feel more better. Like a brand new pair of jeans. Can't take life for granted. I mean, he came into this world innocent, and he's so happy. He doesn't even know how hard he's working and how much I look up to him.
I play basketball with Papa.
Like when I close my eyes and don't even care if anyone sees me dancing. Like I can fly and don't even think of touching the ground. Like a heartbeat skip, like an open page, like a one-way trip on an aeroplane.
A friend of mine who's a doctor over at Straub, and she said, you know, with your chemo, it's like hitting a gnat with a frying pan. And that visual just was like, okay, let's just... I see the scar every day, and it makes me pause for a moment and just think, you have to be grateful. Like a young John Cusack, like making big mistakes. I feel like for the first time. When you survive, I feel privileged to belong to that group of people who've had cancer, and I'm back to my wily ways.
Like when I close my eyes and don't even care if anyone sees me dancing. Like I can fly and I don't even think of touching the ground. Like a heartbeat skip, like an open page, like a one-way trip on an aeroplane. It's the way that I feel when I'm with you.
I was actually diagnosed with a hyperactive thyroid. I mean, I just picked up all this weight. That was where my weight really became a problem. My accomplishment is even greater when I feel that I've inspired other people to either just lose weight, be active, or go as far as I didn't get the surgery. To me, that's the biggest thing, is if I can help others to lead a healthier life.
Like when I close my eyes and don't even care if anyone sees me dancing. Like I can fly and I don't even think I'm touching the ground. Like a heartbeat skip, like an open page, like a one-way trip on an aeroplane. It's the way that I feel when I'm with you. Brand new.
Sometimes the doctors go, oh, we haven't seen you in a while. And I'm thinking, I swear, I felt like I was just, you know, I feel like, you know what? Take it one day at a time. And we just happy and blessings and try to make the most of every day. At every moment, we can make a memory. Boy.
Tree gave me a fruit. Hello, a nurse walking out towards me with Rod. And then when he saw me, his eyeballs opened up like two big apples. To this day, Rod says that I went zigzag. I said, no way, I walked straight to the bed. Go to the doctors, find out where you're at, and I tell you what, you're going to be surprised at how much better you are versus what you think you are.
Hair started to fall out, and I don't know what made me think about creating hair mice, and I started to shape it into a mouse, and that when the hair mice joined our family. I thought it was funny, crazy as that may sound. Go through something like this, you appreciate people around you. That's something that you continue to carry with you.
Two heart attacks in one day. Being a nurse, when I heard all the key words points to a heart attack, then I started getting scared. But at the same time, I said, I gotta make it. I got kids to raise. When I first came back, really nice family members would bring us manapua, malasadas, and all these little snacks. And they would tell me, see, you should have ate it before, because now you really can't eat these things.
Of the rarity and the risk involved with being pregnant to multiple children, we always just was like, let's just take it one day at a time. Whatever we're faced with today is what we'll do today. I mean, we think about the future, but we don't let it overwhelm us. They're just blessings.
Thank you.
do a lot of meditation. And it's not like I'm like, I'm going to beat this, because that's not how I think about cancer. I think about it more like, okay, I'm going to work with this. I don't know what the outcome's going to be, but I can handle this. I've got a sweet, sweet life. There's a new spot to discover. I'm getting back on the horse. My outlook is I just want to enjoy life and be present and contribute to the community and raise awesome kids and surf with my husband, and that's it. I want to drive.
You know, a lot of people who have a near-death experience become better people. They become more conscious about what their lives are about and what's the meaning in life. And I became a better person. I wish I didn't have to have a heart attack to find my missions in life, but it was kind of like getting slapped around real strong and saying, you know what, time to rethink everything. And I did.